Hi, my name is Gene Yang. I am the National Ambassador for Young People's Literature. And today I am with Mike Lawrence for this month's episode of the Reading Without Walls podcast. Thank you so much, Mike, for joining me.
Thank you for having me.
Mike is about to release an amazing graphic novel called Star Scouts. By the time this episode comes out, it'll be available at bookstores everywhere. So first, Mike, tell me a little bit about Star Scouts.
Star Scouts is a story of a girl named Avani Patel who's new in town, and her dad signs her up for Girl Scouts, or I call it Flower Scouts, and try to meet new friends, and she doesn't fit in at all. And then one day, after a really just extra depressing meeting, she gets abducted by an alien scout and is working on her xenobiology badge. And she finds out about Star Scouts, which is, instead of having badges about like makeup and decoupage, they have badges in like jetpacks and lasers and exploration and stuff like that. And so Avani awesome. Then plays hooky from Flower Scouts and ends up just getting beamed up to various spaceships and eventually ends up at a space station for camp.
So can I ask, were you a scout when you were a kid?
I was a scout and I had a horrible experience. It was okay. So boring. I was a Boy Scout. We never left the multi-purpose room of my elementary school, and I always expected like I'd be like out in the woods or like fighting bears. And we just did like paper mache in our cafeteria. And so a little bit about Star Trek.
Okay, so
a little bit of bitter feelings from my childhood. Yeah, it was like I wish this,
you getting back
this should have been cool. It was supposed to be. I mean, I was probably like six, and so they're not going to send six-year-olds to fight bears. So.
Yeah, but it's still disappointing.
It was disappointing.
It's still disappointing. Now, when you were a kid, you were a scout. Were you also a reader?
Avid reader. I'm kind of an introvert, and so books were just one of my best friends growing up. And my mom was an English teacher, and she just fed me anything. Anything I wanted, she would let me read.
So what books were your absolute BFFs then?
My first true love was Narnia. I mean, my mom remembers me sobbing when I finished the last battle, and she told me I could start it all over again, and I immediately did. And so that was like the real gateway for me of fantasy. You know, then you go on to Tolkien. Then I got really into like King Arthur, and I tried reading The Lord Arthur. Fantasy was my book of choice.
I also have to ask, did you ever go outside of that and find a book that you loved that you didn't think you would have loved?
Yeah, since my mom was an English teacher, Scholastic used to have those like book catalogs, they might still do it, and the teachers earned points, and she would let me pick anything I want, and so like she would make sure that I would like read Maniac McGee.
Okay.
Or like The Outsiders. Or something like that, you know, while I'm just chowing through fantasy, she would slip me other books.
And you were happy about that?
Oh yeah, I love Maniac McGee. Like, I still remember just him like running away on the rails, like it's such a great image, and yeah.
So how did you transition from being a reader to becoming a creator?
I was always really into drawing. I went to art school, I studied printmaking, and so, I never felt comfortable as a writer. I would try and not be able to get very far, and so comics was just a way that I could scratch that writer or storytelling itch, but do it all in pictures.
So. Yeah, I had a similar experience.
Yeah.
I feel like when you're making comics, you can just be okay as a writer, okay as an artist, and you can use one, but...
Yeah, to support the other one, and I forget who I was talking to, but they did all their scripts visually, and I was like, I didn't know you could do that.
Oh, yeah, and then Kazu does that. Was it Kazu Kubishi?
Yeah, maybe the same from, like, Bolt City, like, the early days, yes. Like that. And so I was like, and then I tried that, and then it just flew up, you know, it just flowed.
Yeah.
Rather than me doing, like, Avani dialogue, I've never been able to do that.
So for some of us, we have to write with pictures.
Yeah, yeah.
So can I ask for some recommendations? What sort of books are you reading nowadays? Any kids' books or comics?
Right now, so kids' comics, what am I reading my boys right now? We just got Time Museum, because I just got that for a second, and so they've been chewing through that. And then, it's kind of hard, but I've been reading a lot of Pokemon. My kids just discovered it, and so I'm just reading indexes of character stats.
There's some... I've never been a huge fan of Pokemon, but there's got to be something underneath that, right?
Yeah!
It's not just about, like, animal abuse.
No. We've been trying to, like, work their creative play into something that's a little bit more story-driven and why the animals are getting captured and forced to fight each other, and so we're kind of, like, making them think about...
That's good.
Trying to expand on Pokemon.
Awesome. Well, thank you. Thank you so much for joining me on the podcast. And you all need to go check out Star Scouts, available at bookstores everywhere.
Thanks a lot, Mike. Thank you.